Amazon's been trying to get into or expand into sort of the smart home security market, for one thing. The real reason for them is to get people to deliver packages better to homes. I think package theft has become a real problem for, not just for Amazon, for any kind of e-commerce retailer. I live in Brooklyn, don't live in a brownstone, I mean, in a big apartment building with a security guard or like a front doorman sort of thing. So neighbors on my block, they're always complaining about package theft. And so we're always trying to coordinate, hey, did you get that package? Did you get my thing?
Do you feel comfortable letting an Amazon delivery guy into your package up?
Yeah, but that part is a harder sort of, you know, bridge to cross.
I understand the problem. I'm not sure that this is the solution.
They don't sell, though, do they do a Wi-Fi enabled lock?
Amazon itself?
Either Amazon or Ring.
Well, so Ring does the doorbell.
Right.
Amazon actually has a lock system. And they also have a camera system as well. So I think it's a good, smart way to just sort of integrate all these different disparate products into one thing.
Why do you actually need these guys? Basically, why do you need
Amazon
this,
can do this on their own. Why do they need to spend
this is
over
not
a billion
exactly
dollars?
Like rocket science here.
So,
apologies. You know, the people at Ring, I'm sure, have done a great job with this.
Well, I think Amazon had been trying to do it on its own. They had their own product. And I think, you know, Ring, I think what we heard is that their sales, like 2016, were something like 160 million. They have over a million doorbells sold. So there's
already
a big customer base.
Yeah.
And they were using Amazon's cloud service for their video stuff. So I think Amazon got a first look at, like, oh, these guys are doing really well. So if they really want to sort of proliferate this, it might be easier to buy something that's already in the marketplace.
Wait a second, back up for 1 second. You just said they were using Amazon Web Services, and so Amazon got a look at what they were doing. Amazon can spy at what traffic you're doing in the Amazon cloud?
I don't think they're spying on exactly what the actual data is. I think they're saying,
that's an implication that they're looking at everybody else's data.
They're expanding their Amazon Web Services usage. So that tells us,
but they're not actually looking at the
They're not looking at the actual data for sure. They're just looking at, oh, they've become a bigger customer of ours. That tells us they're doing pretty well.
Okay.
So I think
if everybody's getting packages constantly delivered, and there's really a lot of theft, huh?
So they're packages are left on the doorstep, on the porch, or
in
just
urban
on the
settings.
It's happening in the suburbs too. Over the holidays, it started branching out to the suburbs.
So interestingly, by the way,
maybe
we were talking about Coupang.
But
yeah,
the e-commerce company that we showed you in South Korea. They have an amazing delivery service where you actually tell them. Oftentimes, you tell them where to hide the package. Mm-hmm. So you say, hide it behind the bush. Hide it here, and then the driver actually takes a picture of where they left it behind this bush, and then they remember each time.
Amazon has started taking pictures of the delivery stuff on the holidays too.
To show that
we delivered it. It was somebody else who took it.
Well, that's the thing. Like the Coupang example, you in South Korea with their big e-commerce service, they have an end-to-end delivery, right? They own the last mile of the delivery. I think that's an area that Amazon's trying to get more into, for one thing, instead of relying on UPS or FedEx or the postal service. So that's another aspect that Amazon needs to build out in order for this whole thing to work. I think that's the next step for them.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.